So I'm out here at the Maple Shade Town Forest in Westford, and what I thought would be fun to do today would be for me to throw the GoPro on and for you all to see what I see when I'm marking trees to be cut. It's about 25 degrees here right now, early December. It's likely the ground will be frozen pretty soon, and that's when we'll have this small scale logger with a tractor that's gonna come here and cut the trees that I've marked. Our goals for the management of this area, we just want it to be a healthy, diverse, resilient forest. A lot of this forest was pasture within the last 100 years, so we're trying to use the cutting of trees as a tool to help make it more diverse and more like an old growth forest. A diagonal slash of blue paint means that's a tree marked to be cut. The different flagging colors mean different things to different foresters, but in my case, the pink flagging tape is where the skid trails are gonna go. So those are the trails that the equipment that we're using, in this case a tractor, is gonna travel on to pull out those trees that I've marked to be cut.
I'm gonna cut this smaller hemlock tree to give more room to this larger, healthier hemlock tree. I'm gonna cut this one as well to give more room to this bigger, healthier one. Smaller hemlock trees, the logger's not even gonna pull out. He's just gonna cut them as he walks by and just leave them on the ground. Cut this one to give this a bigger hemlock tree and that one more room to grow. Over here we got a diseased beech, yellow birch, crooked hemlock. We wanna give this biggest yellow birch with the biggest crown more room to grow. We're gonna cut this smaller yellow birch, cut this diseased beech, cut this hemlock. There's also these two beeches over here that are pretty clean, pretty smooth bark beech. So they might have some resistance to beech bark disease. So we're gonna leave those there and maybe even cut the red maple that's competing with them. Here are these two trees, this red maple and that red maple. They're competing with each other, and almost always when there's two trees that are the same age, what you're gonna see is that one of their canopies will be sort of asymmetrical, reaching all out to one side, and the other one will have a nice symmetrical canopy. You can't cut the one with the symmetrical canopy without also cutting the other one, because this other one is stunted and actually won't respond to being released that way. So it's either both of the trees, none of the trees, or just the one with the more asymmetrical, less healthy canopy. We have this natural gap that's been created by this big hemlock tree dying and falling over. And so I think what I actually want to do is to expand this gap so we'll have more space to get a little pocket of regeneration. So I'm going to cut this little hemlock tree, that hemlock tree, this red maple tree, maybe this red maple tree, and maybe some trees on the other side of this gap. This tree actually has some dead wood up in the top of it, so I wanna make sure the logger sees that, so I'm gonna put an arrow on this tree pointing up so he knows to look up. So that's south, so this side of the gap, the north side of the gap, is gonna have the most direct sunlight. So if we expand this gap to the north, we're actually gonna get a lot better regeneration. Take this hemlock tree. That beech tree is already basically dead. This little guy dropped on the ground. Over here, we're going to leave this yellow birch tree, but we'll cut some of these smaller hemlock trees. This one, this hemlock tree, this bigger red maple tree, smaller red maple tree. Within that gap, this is a bigger, older hemlock tree. I don't think it probably has any financial value anyway, and tremendous wildlife value. So within that gap, we're going to leave this as a legacy tree. Okay, so what we got here now is probably a quarter of an acre gap that's built around two natural gaps caused by a windstorm. And like a natural disturbance, we're also leaving retention within the gap. So individual trees within this area that are still going to be perch sites and biological legacies into that next generation that's going to regenerate here naturally.